हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय प्लेलिस्ट ऑफ क्लिनिकल न्यूरो एनाटॉमी जो हम इस चैनल से कर रहे हैं एंड दोज ऑफ यू हु हैव बीन फॉलोइंग माय चैनल ऑलरेडी नो द पैटर्न कि हमने चैप्टर नंबर 10 बेसल गैंग्लिया ऑलरेडी डिस्कस किया हुआ है एंड उसकी जो क्लिनिकल नोट्स थे वो हम हर चैप्टर को ऑब्वियसली छोड़ते गए थे वो अब मैं कवर कर रहा हूँ. सो नाउ इफ यू हैव वॉच्ड माय वीडियो ऑन बेसल गैंग्लिया ऑलरेडी यू विल अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट. सो वेरी क्विकली व्हाट आर बेसल गैंग्लिया. दीज आर बेसिकली इफ यू रिमेंबर इट दिस टर्मिनोलॉजी अप्लाइज टू अ कलेक्शन ऑफ मासेस ऑफ ग्रे मैटर सिचुएटेड विद इन ईच सेरिब्रल हेमिस्फीयर. तो जो आपका सेरिब्रल हेमिस्फीयर है उसके अंदर देर आर मासेस ऑफ ग्रे मैटर विच मीन्स द सेल बॉडीज ऑफ सम पर्टिकुलर न्यूरॉन्स. And those collections are known as basal nuclei or basal ganglia. And they are actually divided into three different terminologies. Basically, ek hai corpus striatum, then is amygdala, and then amygdaloid nucleus, basically. And then number third is colostrum. Ye teeno milkar banate hain basal ganglia. Aur basically, basal ganglia ka function hai to control the posture and the movement. So, they basically primarily control postural स्ट्रक्चर. आपकी बॉडी का पॉस्चर क्या रहेगा यानी मसल्स की टोन एंड ऑल दीज थिंग्स एंड द वॉलेंट्री मूवमेंट. सो दैट्स अ वेरी बिग डोमेन एक्चुअली. आप जो भी काम वॉलेंटरिली कर रहे हैं, कोई चीज पिक कर रहे हैं, चल रहे हैं, वॉक कर रहे हैं, लेट रहे हैं, बैठ रहे हैं, उठ रहे हैं, एनी थिंग यू इमेजिन जिसमें स्केलेटल मसल्स की मूवमेंट इन्वॉल्व हैं, दीज आर द वॉलेंट्री मूवमेंट्स. और आपका जो पॉस्चर है, आप बैठे हैं तो कैसा पॉस्चर है, खड़े हैं, सो ऑल दीज आर कंट्रोल्ड बाय बेसल गैंग्लिया. एंड वी हैव कंप्लीटेड दिस चैप्टर इन ग्रेट डिटेल, डिफरेंट पाथवेज, डिफरेंट स्ट्रक्चर्स. टुडे आवर टास्क इज टू गो थ्रू द क्लिनिकल सिनेरियोज एसोसिएटेड विद बेसल गैंग्लिया. सो दो तरह के डिसऑर्डर्स हैं जो बेसल गैंग्लिया अगर अफेक्टेड होगा तो उसके साथ इन्वॉल्व होंगे. एक को हम कहते हैं जिसमें मूवमेंट बढ़ जाती है, ऑब्वियसली अनकंट्रोल्ड मूवमेंट, यानी योर बॉडी स्टार्ट्स रिस्पॉन्डिंग इन अ वे दैट इट इज मूविंग. जो वॉलंटरी मूवमेंट होनी चाहिए थी अब वो इनवॉलंटरली बहुत ज्यादा हो रही है. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड हाइपरकाइनेटिक डिसऑर्डर इन विच द मूवमेंट्स इंक्रीज एंड द अदर वन इज नोन एज हाइपोकाइनेटिक डिसऑर्डर जिसमें मूवमेंट डिक्रीज हो जाती है. सो डिसऑर्डर्स ऑफ द बेसल गैंग्लिया आर जनरली डिवाइडेड इनटू टू टाइप्स. नंबर वन हाइपरकाइनेटिक मूवमेंट्स एंड नंबर टू हाइपोकाइनेटिक मूवमेंट्स. हाइपरकाइनेटिक मूवमेंट्स वो हैं which involve excessive and abnormal movements such as, अब इसकी further तीन categories जो आपको definitely नाम पता होने चाहिए. One is known as chorea, the other one is known as athetosis, and then there is balism. So ये तीनों are hyperkinetic disorders, okay? So chorea, athetosis and balism. Then we have hypokinetic disorders, or hypokinetic disorders involve lack or slowness of the movement. So नाम से भी जाहिर है hypokinetic and hyperkinetic, so you can have an idea. And one particular disease which has component of both hyperkinetic as well as hypokinetic movement is known as Parkinson's disease. It includes both types of motor disturbances involving hyperkinetic state as well as hypokinetic state. So that's the very nice introductory paragraph to the disorders associated with basal ganglia. Okay? Ab kuch particular diseases pe inhone thoda sa elaborate kiya hai. So first one is the chorea, which is now you know a hyperkinetic movement. In chorea, the patient exhibits involuntary, quick, jerky, irregular movements that are non-repetitive. Swift grimaces and sudden movements of the head and limbs are good examples. So अचानक से हाथ को झटका लग रहा है, सर को झटका लग रहा है, so these things are called chorea. Involuntary movement है, quick movement है, jerky movements है, so all these make sense. Huntington disease is an autosomal dominant inherited disease. Very important line. That's an autosomal dominant because अगर ये word आप miss करते हो then you miss the whole inheritance pattern. So in order to understand the inheritance pattern you need to know what is autosomal dominant, okay? And this is one of the example of autosomal dominant disorder. With the onset occurring mostly in the adult life, death occurs 15 to 20 years after the onset. So that's pretty lethal disease. Yani diagnosis ke 15-20 saal mein the person is gone. The disease has been traced to a single gene defect on chromosome number 4 and the gene encodes for a protein which is known as Huntington. So aapke pure genome mein ye cell hai, ye nucleus hai, usme chromosome hai, so a particular gene hai chromosome number 4 pe, us gene ka kaam hai to code for a protein which is known as Huntington that is mutated. The codon CIG that encodes glutamine is repeated many more times than the normal. So there is a CAG repeat. So in Huntington disease, ये जो nucleotide है ये बहुत ज़्यादा दफ़ा repeated, और जब बहुत ज़्यादा दफ़ा repeated होगा तो वो protein abnormal बनेगी. The disease affect men and women equal frequency, and you know this is autosomal dominant, and that's the trait then. And unfortunately reveals itself only after they have had children. So which means that the mutations are usually also transferred into the next generation, and after that they are. So if this is the parent and the person has the mutation for Huntington disease until you know marriage life and the person is fine, but usually it is manifested in this person once the person has already have the babies. इसका मतलब ये है कि अब इस बंदे को पता लग रहा है कि मेरे अंदर ये डिजीज है, तो बाय द टाइम इसमें डायग्नोज होती है यहां तक वो डिजीज पहुंच चुकी होती है. सो दैट्स समथिंग नॉट गुड. Patients have the following characteristic signs and symptoms. Number one is the coriform movement. So, chorea ke context mein Huntington disease, coriform movement first appear as involuntary movement of the extremities and twitching of the face, which is called facial grimacing. Achanak se face mein twitches hain. Later, more muscle groups are involved, so the patient becomes absolutely immobile and unable to speak or swallow. And this is where it becomes very, very serious. Another thing involved is the progressive dementia. Loss of memory and intellectual capacity is gone with the passage of time. In the disease, GABA secreting, substance P secreting and acetylcholine secreting neurons of the striatonigral, you know the striatonigral was an inhibitory pathway, they degenerate. Now once the inhibitory pathway is degenerated, there is over movement, hyperkinetic disorder. Okay, and this is what happens in the whole thing. This inhibition produces so inhibition of the inhibitory pathway, so that's important to understand that the inhibition of the inhibitory pathway leads to abnormal movements which is seen in this particular disease. Medical treatment of Huntington chorea has been very, very disappointing, which means that there is no success. So chorea is sudden jerky movement. Chorea is generalized bigger name जो कि एक इम्पॉर्टेंट क्लिनिकल प्रेजेंटेशन है फॉर द हाइपरकाइनेटिक डिसऑर्डर. फिर कोरिया के एग्जांपल्स में हंटिंगटन डिजीज है जिसमें कोरिया होता है. देन वी हैव सैइडेनहैम कोरिया, ऑल्सो कॉल्ड द सेंट वाइटस डांस, इज अ डिजीज ऑफ चाइल्डहुड. सो देर इज अ डिफरेंस. अगर पेशेंट एग्जाम में आपके सामने आएगा द पेशेंट फॉर हंटिंगटन डिजीज विल बी अ लिटिल एजेड एज कम्पेयर टू द सैइडेनहैम कोरिया विच विल बी यू नो चिल्ड्रन. सो एज इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. जब कभी एग्जाम में क्वेश्चन आपके सामने लिखा हुआ आता है क्लिनिकल विनियत में, सो एज बिकम्स एन इंपॉर्टेंट इंडिकेटर ऑफ व्हाट दे आर ट्राइंग टू टेल यू. सो इफ दे आर स्टार्टिंग विद लाइक 4 इयर्स ओल्ड चाइल्ड एंड 28 इयर्स ओल्ड गाय, सो देयर इज अ डिफरेंस. यू फॉर 28 इयर्स यू विल नॉट बी थिंकिंग अबाउट सैइडेनहैम कोरिया, एंड फॉर 4 इयर्स परहैप्स यू विल नॉट बी थिंकिंग अबाउट हंटिंगटन. ओके, द कंडीशन इज एसोसिएटेड विद रूमेटिक फीवर. अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंटर, the antigens of the streptococcal bacteria are very much similar in structure to the proteins which are present in the membranes of the striatal neuron. Corpus striatum ki baat ho rahi hai. And those antibodies which are actually initiated against the bacteria go and attack the you know striatal pathways, and therefore there is degeneration because of this attack of the basal ganglia. This results in the production of coriform movement which are fortunately transient, and full recovery is usually made. So ये पूरा क्लिनिकल सेटअप सैइडेनहैम कोरिया का इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द हंटिंगटन डिजीज. दैट्स एन इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट टू रिमेंबर. ओके, देन हेमीबॉलिज्मस इज अ फॉर्म ऑफ इनवॉलंटरी मूवमेंट कन्फाइंड टू ओनली वन साइड ऑफ द बॉडी. इट यूजुअली इन्वॉल्व्स प्रॉक्सिमल एक्सट्रीमिटी मस्कुलेचर एंड लिम्ब सडनली फ्लाइज अबाउट आउट ऑफ कंट्रोल इन ऑल द डायरेक्शन. सो दिस इज हाउ द पेशेंट प्रेजेंट द लीजन, बट दैट विल ओनली बी हैपनिंग ऑन वन साइड ऑफ द बॉडी. The lesion, which is usually a small stroke, occurs in the opposite subthalamic nucleus or its connections. Smooth movements of different parts of the body are integrated in the subthalamic nuclei. So, her disease mein, there is something important to pick up for answering in the right direction. So, Huntington, important pointers we discussed, Sydenham chorea, and then hemibalismus, one half of the body. Parkinson disease will have both components, hyperkinetic as well as hypokinetic. It's a progressive disease of unknown cause basically. It's a very important thing to know ke iski cause ye abhi tak nahi pata chali. And the age of commencement is usually in middle aged, you know, 45, 55, depending upon where you live in the world. Either it is middle aged or sometimes it is young as well. It is associated with neuronal degeneration in the substantia nigra and to lesser extent in the globus pallidus, putamen and caudate nucleus. So, aap ye ek baat note kar rahe hain ki jitni bhi abhi tak hum diseases discuss kar rahe hain, majority of them are actually affecting substantia nigra. The disease affects about 1 million people in the United States. So, that's a big number actually. 1 million is a big number. Okay, The degeneration of the neuron in the substantia nigra that send their axon to the corpus striatum result in reduction in the release of neurotransmitter dopamine within the corpus striatum, because you know this is the main neurotransmitter released in corpus striatum. Or because of degeneration and lack of dopamine, this leads to hypersensitivity of the dopamine receptor, because dopamine is not there. They are empty. They are thirsty for dopamine and dopamine is not there. And patients have the following characteristics: tremors, rigidity, bradykinesis, postural disturbances, and we'll go through all of them one by one. Tremors is the result of alternating contraction of agonist and antagonistic muscles. So, you know, in your body you have, so for example, if you're talking about arm and then forearm, so here we have bicep, which is a flexor, and then we have a tricep, which is an extensor at the elbow joint. So if there is an alternate contraction of bicep, it will be flexion; tricep, it will be extension. So you know, this will if this continues for a time, this is known as tremor. Imagine your forearm and elbow joint going flex and extended all the time. Rigidity, this differ from the rigidity caused by also the upper motor neuron lesion, because upper motor neuron lesion may be there is rigidity of the musculature, but there's a difference between the Parkinson rigidity and upper neuron lesion rigidity, okay, that is present to an equal extent in the opposing muscle group. If the tremor is absent, the rigidity is felt as resistance to passive movement and is sometimes known as plastic rigidity. If the tremor is present, the muscle resistance is overcome by a series of jerks, and that is what is known as cogwheel rigidity. Now, students, ye do points, they are super important to understand. एग्जाम में ये बहुत पूछे जाते हैं. मैं भी वाइवा में ये सवाल बहुत करता हूँ, एंड आई हेयर माय कोलीग्स इन पेयर्स आस्किंग दिस क्वेश्चन क्वाइट अ लॉट कि टेल मी द डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन प्लास्टिक एंड कॉगव्हील रिजिडिटी, एंड देयर इज अ सिंपल डिफरेंशिएटिंग मैकेनिज्म बिटवीन द टू. And the mechanism to differentiate between the two is simply ask or observe if there are tremors associated or not. If there are no jerky tremor movements, then this is what is called plastic rigidity. If the tremors are there, this is cogwheel rigidity. Okay, then bradykinesis. Initiating akinesia and performing new movements is difficult in these patients. The movements are slow, face is expressionless, and the voice is slurred. And all this is collectively under the umbrella of bradykinesis. Because what's happening? That dopamine secreting neurons, corpus striatum, they are degenerated. Postural disturbances, the patient stands with a stoop and his arm flexed. The patient walks by taking short steps and often unable to stop. Continue movement hoti hai to wo rukna uske liye mushkil hai, chalta rehta hai. In fact, he or she may break into shuffling and run to maintain the balance. So all this is actually understandable. The reason being, aapko maine start mein bataya tha, aur ye alag se jo humne is chapter ki puri video kar rakhi hai, usme humne ye discuss kiya bhi hai ki the major function of basal nuclei is basically to control the posture and the movement. So ye samajhna mushkil nahi hona chahiye ki if the basal ganglia are affected, if the neurons are degenerated, such as what is happening in Parkinson's disease, there are disturbances involved in postural control and voluntary movement. So this point particularly reflect ke jo inka primary kaam tha, yani ke posture or movement ka control, wo ab disturb ho gaya hai. Neither loss of muscle power nor loss of sensibility occurs since the corticospinal tracts are fine. So that's important. Muscle power is fine. It's just the control of normal movements which is affected. Okay, and no Babinski response is seen, again because the tracts are okay. The deep tendon reflexes are also normal. That's an important point to differentiate between other tract disorders and Parkinson. Okay, in a few types of Parkinson disease, is the cause is known. Post encephalitis, for example, developed following viral encephalitis outbreaks in early 20th century, in which damage occurred in the basal nuclei after viral encephalitis. Iatrogenic is induced by medical cause, so such as any antipsychotic. Patient on antipsychotics may present with Parkinson's diseases. And meperidine analogs, which is very commonly used by certain drug addicts, and poisoning from carbon monoxide poisoning can also lead to Parkinson-like symptoms. Atherosclerotic Parkinsonism can occur in elderly hypertensive patients as well. So now imagine, hypertension is very common, atherosclerosis is very common, therefore old age may Parkinson also become a common disorder. Parkinson disease may be treated by elevating the brain dopamine level, because that's the primary issue. The primary issue is that the dopamine releasing neurons are damaged in substantia nigra. So if you replace dopamine somehow, that will be in betterment of the patient. Unfortunately, dopamine cannot cross the blood-brain barrier, but its immediate precursor L-DOPA can cross. So we make use of this information, and L-DOPA is taken up by the dopaminergic neurons in the basal nuclei. So you basically treat the patient with L-DOPA. Okay. Selegiline, a drug that inhibits monoamine oxidase, which is responsible for destroying dopamine, also sometimes help, because if you don't destroy dopamine, the levels go up for transient time periods. Transplantation of human embryonic dopamine producing neuron, that's something new, into directly caudate nucleus and putamen has been tried by some, at least, okay? But kitni iski success hai, that's a question. Evidence show that graft can survive and synaptic contacts are made after, but this is not a 100% type of response. Since most of the symptoms of Parkinson's disease are caused by increased inhibitory output from the basal nuclei to the thalamus and precentral motor gyrus, surgical involvement such as globus pallidus part remove karna, pallidotomy, things like that, you know, they have been tried, but again the success rate has been questionable. Now there is a very segregated category called drug induced Parkinsonism. कुछ ड्रग्स तो मैंने यहाँ आपको नाम बताए थे जिनसे पार्किंसोनिज्म हो सकता है. आइट्रोजेनिक में वी टॉक्ड अबाउट एंटीसाइकोटिक्स, पर्टिकुलरली फिनोथाइजिन्स. सो ऑल्दो पार्किंसन डिजीज इज द मोस्ट कॉमन टाइप ऑफ पार्किंसोनिज्म फाउंड इन क्लिनिकल प्रैक्टिस, विच इज बिकॉज ऑफ द लॉस ऑफ डोपामिनर्जिक न्यूरॉन्स, ड्रग इंड्यूस इज ऑल्सो नॉट वेरी अनकॉमन. Drugs that block the striatal dopamine receptor, particularly D2, are often the psychotic behavior के लिए वो ड्रग्स दी जाती हैं. जैसे अभी ऊपर मैंने बताया भी था आपको phenothiazines या even butyrophenones. Other drugs may deplete the striatal dopamine, including tetrabenazine. So psychotic treatment के लिए जो ड्रग्स यूज हो रही हैं, they can have their Parkinson-like effects. Okay? Athetosis consists of slow, sinuous, writhing movements that most commonly involve the distal segments of the limb. Degeneration of the globus pallidus occurs. So that's, not very common and therefore not very much asked in the exam. The main thing is the chorea and the hyperkinetic disorders, okay? Now, what are they showing in these particular images? So that is the PET scan of a normal brain. So if you look at it, this is the normal brain. And this is the brain with early Parkinson disease, you see. And what they have injected the patient with is 18 fluorodopa. The normal brain image shows large amount of this compound distributed throughout the corpus striatum. You see, this is the fluorescent signal here. So let me change the color so that you understand it better. Is this better? Let me check. Yeah. So that's the fluorescent system. Ye aapko nazar aa raha hai jo aapne compound inject kiya in the corpus striatum. दोनों cerebral hemisphere में दिख रहा है. Patient जिसमें Parkinson disease है, the brain image shows the total amount of compound is low and it's unevenly distributed in the corpus striatum. You see how it is distributed. Compare this with this and also some uneven distribution here and there. So that is one scan which is used clinically to identify Parkinson. What this is talking about is changes 18 fluorodopa uptake in brains of patient with Parkinson disease after transplantation. So basically they're trying to show, okay, before surgery, look at the amount of the dye taken in the basal ganglia, and then after surgery, you see what's happening here. So perhaps the stem cells are working, the transplantation is working. Obviously, you have to check कि जो आपने transplant किए हैं dopamine releasing stem cells, if they are working or not. And the only way to check this is if the dye is being taken up or not. So that's sort of the image this is. So these are the most important clinical concerns that I had to discuss for chapter number 10, which is about basal ganglia. So now we are done with basal ganglia. Aapse mulaqat hogi agle kisi chapter mein, where we will be discussing clinical notes of another chapter of neuroanatomy from Snell. So all the very best, stay tuned.